Welcome back to the show. Australian women and children right now trapped in volatile and unsafe Syrian detention camps will soon be heading home to Australia.
So the federal government preparing to launch a major repatriation mission for the families of ISIS fighters under heavy security. Here to discuss more is CEO of Save the Children, Matt Tinkler from Coolum Beach in Queensland. Matt, good morning to you. How are you this morning?
Morning, Carl. Really well, thank you.
I want you to know we're a broad church of opinion on this matter this morning before we hit you with our questions. But details of this operation, they're slowly leaking out, which, to be honest with you, I find, frankly, not good enough from the federal government. They need to be upfront about all this. But apparently some of these women will face charges as soon as they return here. They may be detained straight away. Some will have to wear ankle monitors, some of them separated from their children. Have you been told what charges they may face?
No, I haven't been told what charges they'll face, but I did go and visit these women and the innocent children in the camps in northeast Syria earlier this year. And I asked every one of those women, are you willing to cooperate fully with law enforcement authorities on your arrival? And to a person, they said yes. I also discussed whether they'd be prepared to submit to a control order. That's the kind of order you mentioned, where their every movement could be monitored through an ankle bracelet, through house arrest, through their communications being limited. So I think we need to put our faith in Australia's very robust judicial and national security architecture. We can mitigate any risk that these women may pose. The real emphasis right now needs to be on saving those very innocent kids in a really, really vulnerable situation right now.
Look, Matt, this is an issue that Carl and I, you know, we disagree on this one. I think you do have to trust your security agencies to do the job here. But you do also have to concede that this does come with risks. These are people who have seen things and been exposed to things, and we don't know what that has done to them.
Yeah, it's true. There is risks here both ways. I tell you what, the greatest risk right now is that an Aussie child who is innocent will die in those camps in northeast Syria. Hundreds of kids have died in these camps in the last few years. An Australian boy who was transported from the camps to an adult prison died earlier this year. So we've got to ask ourselves, how much is an innocent Australian child's life worth? I think those risks can be mitigated here. We have invested billions over many years in a very robust national security system here. It's a great deal better than the system that exists in northeast Syria right now. So there's no prospect that these women would face trial or charges under the Kurdish administration that's in place there. So really, we might not like this choice we've got, but the only choice we can really take here is to do the right thing by our citizens and by these children and bring them home.
I guess the biggest risk too for innocent Australians back here is that de-radicalisation hasn't worked, and we don't know the success or failure of that. Is that worth the risk?
Well, I think it is, Carl. And we know that in 2019, a group of seven Australian orphans were repatriated from this very situation. By all reports, they're living back in the Australian community very well and without risk to Australia right now. So we've got form on this in Australia. We've got some of the best law enforcement, welfare, social security, mental health supports available anywhere in the world. We've got to trust that they're up to the job, because the alternative is we just leave these kids to a terrible fate. And we also put the burden on our former allies in the Middle East who fought the war against ISIS, and are now being forced to bear this burden on behalf of very comparatively wealthy governments like Australia.
Do you concede that this is incredibly painful, distressing, traumatic for war veterans?
Oh, look, I concede this is a really difficult thing for Australia to go through. And yes, I can understand some people have very mixed views on this. But what I would say is there is not really an alternative here. Other countries like the US, France, Germany, Belgium, Netherlands, Sweden, Russia, Kazakhstan have all made this difficult choice to repatriate their citizens because they feel it's the right thing to do and the just thing to do. So we might need to do this through gritted teeth, Carl, but I think we need to do it regardless.
Good to talk to you. Thanks for coming on. We appreciate it.
Thanks, Matt.